sister. How you doing, sister? What's your name again? Alicia. Okay, Alicia, I'm a Hosiah. How you doing, sister? All right, good. So the officer brought out who you were and what you must do, right? Did you know that the Israelites has a dietary law? You didn't know that we had a dietary law? Certain things that we can eat, certain things that we can't eat. Okay, well, we're going to get that for you. Get that Leviticus 11.
Leviticus chapter 11 and verse 2. Huh? Speak unto the children of Israel.
So this is the children of Israel, them people on that sign, the blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans. Those are the children of Israel. And this is what the Lord is telling Moses to speak to the children of Israel. Read.
Saying, these are the beasts which ye shall eat among all the beasts that are on the earth.
So this is what we're supposed to eat that's on the earth, the beast that's on the earth, all right?
Read. Whatsoever part of the hoof and is cloven footed and cheweth the cud among the beasts, that shall ye eat.
So that beast is what it's talking about, is the cow, right? That's what we're supposed to eat. We're supposed to eat beef because the cow foot is cloven footed. You know what that means by cloven foot? It means that when you wear your slippers and you got the thongs or whatever that split in between, that means it's cloven foot, right? So that's what the cow eats. The cow has on his hoof.
Right.
Plus he eat the cud. He chew the cud, meaning the grass. So meaning that he has a digestive system.
Right.
Right? He can digest, he regurgitate, and then he chews it up again and digest it again. You see what I'm saying? So that's what we're supposed to eat. That's the clean beef. Read.
Verse 4. Nevertheless, these shall ye not eat of them.
So this is what you're not supposed to eat. Well, just skip the 7.
Verse 7. And the swine, though he devoured the hoof.
So you know what the swine is, right? The swine is what? The pig. Come on.
And be cloven footed, yet he cheweth not the cud.
Can't digest. Come on.
He is unclean to you.
So he is unclean to you. Read.
Of their flesh shall ye not eat.
See, you say you don't need to eat that. He's telling you don't eat it. That's a commandment. And that's what our people got away from. That's why we, you know, some of us be heavy set. You see what I'm saying? It's hard for us to lose weight. Why? Because we ain't eating right.
Bring it on.
Come on, read.
And their carcass shall ye not touch.
That means you don't pick it up and put it up to your mouth to eat it. That's what that means. So don't eat the swine. Come on, read on.
They are unclean to you. Verse 9. These shall ye eat of all that are in the waters.
So these are what you're supposed to eat that's in the waters. In the waters. You know what I'm talking about? We're talking about now we're going into the fish. Right? In the waters. Come on.
Whatsoever have fins and scales.
See, whatsoever have fins and scales. It's got to have both of them on it. Come on.
In the waters, in the seas, mm-hmm. and in the rivers, mm-hmm. them shall ye eat.
So you're supposed to eat that. Fish with fins and scales.
Right.
Come on, read.
Verse 10. And all that have not fins and scales.
So the fish that don't have fins and scales. Come on.
In the seas.
In the seas.
And in the rivers.
Or in the rivers.
Or all of all that move in the waters.
Everything that move in the waters without fins and scales. Come on.
And of any living thing which is in the waters.
Uh-huh.
They shall be an abomination unto you.
You see that? That's an abomination. So what is going into? It's going into catfish.
Right.
That's going into shrimp.
Right.
Lobsters.
Right.
Crawfish.
Yes,
you understand? We ain't supposed to eat that stuff.
Right.
That stuff give us that plague. It give us that curse.
Right.
That ain't written in the book of the law. It's going to kill us.
Right.
That's what the Lord said. He's going to place it upon us until we die.
That's right.
So we ain't supposed to eat that stuff. Now you know the dietary law, right? Did the officer go over you with the fringes? The fringes. He ain't go over you with the fringes. Okay. Well, let's get that. But we're going to show you today, sister. We're just going to bring out some laws, sister. All right? We're gonna build you up so you can understand what we stand for and what you should stand for and what every black, Hispanic, and Native American man, woman, or child is supposed to stand for, and that's the laws of God.
That's right.
All right, come on.
Numbers chapter 15, verse 38. Speak unto the children of Israel.
This is you. Come on.
And bid them that they make them fringes in the borders of their garments.
You see what every brother got on out here at the bottom of his garment? His shirt. You see that? Those are fringes. Read.
Throughout their generations.
As long as we keep having children, this is what we're supposed to wear. Come on.
And that they put upon the fringe of the borders a ribbon of blue.
So that's the ribbon of blue around it. We're supposed to put that on top of it. It don't matter. It ain't got to be the dark blue, but it's got to be something blue. Okay? It could be this color blue, this light blue, or whatever. As long as it's blue over the fringes, that's a commandment from the Lord. Come on, read on.
And it shall be unto you for a fringe, that ye may look upon it and remember all the commandments of the Lord and do them.
So that's what the fringe is for. It's for you to look at and remember the commandments and do it. Remember that dietary law.
Right.
You see? Don't eat the pork. Don't eat the crab. Don't eat the shrimp, lobster, catfish, crawfish. Don't eat those things. If you get tempted, that's when you look at the fringe and say, you know what? The Lord say, don't eat this, so I'm not going to eat it.
That's right.
That's what we're supposed to do here. Come on, read.
And that ye seek not after your own heart.
Don't go after your own lust. Come on.
And your own eyes. After which ye used to go a whoring.
After which you see everybody else is doing and they telling you, oh, you ain't going to die. Everything all right. No, that's not.
Right.
The Lord say don't do it. Because you know the wages of sin is death, right? You know that, right? We learn that in the Christian church, but they don't follow.
Right.
Because as soon as they leave, they're going to have service tomorrow. As soon as they leave, where they going? Going to the buffet. Eating up a pork, crab, shrimp, and lobster. They're not teaching you. We are your teachers out here.
That's right.
We're your teachers. So we want you to do what's right. All right, you got any other questions? Okay. Bring out the pants for the sister. We're going to bring out another law, Deuteronomy 22 and 5. Because our sisters are supposed to dress righteously, sis.
Teach us!
See, today's society got us thinking the way we dress now is righteous.
Right.
No, you see these men with these fringes on? We dress righteous.
That's right.
Why? Because the laws of God is righteous.
That's right.
Come on, let's get that.
Deuteronomy chapter 22. And verse 5,
bring it out.
The woman shall not wear that which pertaineth unto a man.
So the woman is not supposed to wear what pertains to a man, right? Read.
Neither shall a man put on a woman's garment.
So what is a woman's garment? Garment means clothes. What's a woman's clothing? When you say that, that's a woman. What clothes she got on? You don't know? Okay, come on. We're going to read it again.
For all that do so are abomination unto the Lord thy God.
Read from the top.
Deuteronomy chapter 22 and verse 5. The woman shall not wear that which pertaineth unto a man.
So you're a woman, right? We are men out here. What do all these men wearing right now? Fringes? What else? What? Black what? Read from the top.
The woman shall not wear that which pertaineth unto a man.
So the black pants or pants pertains to men.
Right.
So God is telling you, women shouldn't wear what men wear.
Right.
Read.
Neither shall a man put on a woman's garment.
So a man ain't supposed to put on a dress. That's a woman's garment. You see what I'm saying? All these sisters around here saying that they queens. But they dress like thots.
Right.
Straight up. And I'm not calling you a thot sister. What I'm telling you, you are a daughter of Sarah.
That's right.
You're supposed to wear a dress because that's the commandment of God. So the woman don't wear pants. Man don't wear a dress.
Right.
Who was that Young Thug and all of them?
Right.
Will Smith and Tyler Perry. Man, all them people wearing dress. Them men wearing dresses. They crazy as hell, ain't they? That's what I'm talking about. The Lord is telling us, he told us that from the beginning.
Right.
That's why we're in these conditions today.
Right.
Give me that 1 Timothy 2.
Bring it out.
Let's get 1 Timothy 2.
1 Timothy chapter 2 and verse 9. In like manner also, that the woman adorned themselves in modest apparel.
You know what modest means? Modest means not drawing sexual attention to yourself.
Right.
Long, loose-fitting dresses is the way the Israelite woman is supposed to dress.
That's right.
Put that fringe with the ribbon, the blue on the bottom of it to remind you of the commandments.
That's right.
You see, right now, see, I'm telling you right now, you're out of order according to the Most High. All right? According to this world, you good, sister. Them niggas over there, they don't know what they talking about. But nah, they don't know what they talking about.
That's right.
Because if they ain't following these commandments, they gonna get put to death.
Right.
You know, nuclear bombs is coming to this place, sister.
Right.
I'm glad you're standing here humble and you listening and you understanding. But now it's time for you to apply
right.
What God is telling you to do today. We just reading his words.
Right.
Right? So the spandex, sister, don't wear that no more. Don't wear the pants. Don't wear shorts. Wear a long, loose-fitting dress.
Right.
And you're going to see the reaction out of these men. These men got a harsh mind. You see what I'm saying? We used to be that way. We repented of that.
Right.
And still repenting of it.
Right.
You see what I'm saying? Because sin is still out here.
Right.
So read that again from the top.
1 Timothy chapter 2 and verse 9.
Yeah.
In like manner also, that the woman adorn themselves in modest apparel.
Modest apparel meaning not drawing sexual attention. Come on.
With shamefacedness.
Be ashamed to be all up in the man's face.
Right.
Nowadays, these women don't care. They all in the man's face like they a man. You see what I'm saying? Or they have that horse mentality.
Right.
In the man's face. Hey, baby. What's up, baby? What's this? You understand what I'm talking about? That's why you live. You know what I'm saying. So what we're saying is out of the Holy Bible that this is how you're supposed to dress.
Right.
In modest apparel with shamefacedness. Come on.
And sobriety.
Be sober. Don't be all drunk out here and high. Come on.
Not with broided hair or gold or pearls or costly array.
It's not about how you look with those things on. Read.
But. Which becometh women professing godliness.
You see, you profess godliness when you keep the commandments of God.
That's right.
That shows these men out here. That shows these women, these little sisters out here. I heard him go over Titus 2. I think he went over Titus 2.
Right.
He went over that. So you're supposed to be the example for these little sisters out here. Because these little girls, what they doing? They following the ways of their mama. Or they ain't it. Or they cousin. Or, yeah, like you say, Cardi B.
Bring it out.
Yeah, you see, hey, give me Deuteronomy 23 and 17.
Bring it out.
You see, this is what the Lord ordained for the children of Israel, especially the women, not to do.
Right.
Men are supposed to raise their children.
Right.
The righteous way.
Right.
But a lot of men have fell away from these commandments, and now they're letting their children go out wild.
That's right.
They letting the woman go out wild.
Right.
You see, but this is what God said about us to raise our, how to raise our children. Read.
Deuteronomy chapter 23 and verse 17. There shall be no whore of the daughters of Israel.
Read that again.
Deuteronomy 23 verse 17. There shall be no whore of the daughters of Israel.
Blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans. There's to be no whores of the daughters of Israel.
That's right.
Read.
Nor a sodomite of the sons of Israel.
Now a sodomite. A sodomite is a homosexual.
Right.
So ain't no man of Israel supposed to be a homosexual.
That's right.
God said, marry, multiply. Didn't he say? It means procreate.
Right.
How you gonna procreate if you're a homosexual?
Right.
Or a lesbian?
Right.
See that? That's that disease.
Huh.
You get diseases from that.
Right.
The curse. What ain't written in the book of the law? AIDS ain't written in there. Now they got super gonorrhea. You ever heard of that? Look it up. Blue waffle? Yeah. They probably gonna have something called black waffle or something. I don't know. But if we keep on not keeping these commandments, it's gonna be something worse than COVID-19.
That's right.
It's gonna be something worse than that super gonorrhea. It's gonna be something unheard of. Probably just blow up and just get put back together and blow up again.
Right.
Ain't no telling what the Lord got.
Right.
But he's telling you to keep his commandments.
That's
you
right.
love Christ, right? John 14:15. You love Christ. Right. And they told you the real Christ over there, right? So now you know he looked just like me. He looked just like you, right? Right. That's our father. That's our brother. That's our cousin. That's what we're supposed to look up to.
That's right.
You understand? We're supposed to follow his ways. Come on, read that.
John 14:15. If ye love me, keep my commandments.
You see what Christ said? Christ said, if you love him, keep his commandments. You see? 1 John 5:3. Christ said, if you love him, keep his commandments. And this is what the Bible says. This is what love is.
1 John 5:3. For this is the love of God.
This is the love of God. Come on.
That we keep his commandments.
That we keep his commandments. Come on.
And his commandments are not grievous.
His commandments are not grievous, meaning not hard to do. How hard is it for you to put on pants over the tights right there? A dress. Over that. That's to cover up.
Right.
Hey, give me Exodus 28 and start at verse 4. I'm gonna show you who pants were instituted to. As you got to realize, when we were in Egypt, we was under the Egyptian captivity. So these laws only came out in detail after we left out of Egypt. So these Egyptians had us following their ways, right? But this, when we left out of Egypt, God commanded Moses to command the children of Israel to do this. This is what pants was instituted for.
Deuteronomy 28:4. And these are the garments which they shall make: a breastplate and an ephod and a robe, and a body coat and mitre.
Verse 42.
And thou shalt make them linen breeches.
You know what breeches are? Huh? Pants. Remember Big Mama. Big Mama say breeches. Boy, pull up your breeches, boy. You see what I'm saying? That's what my grandma used to tell me. All right? Come on. Linen breeches. Come on.
To cover their nakedness.
To cover their nakedness. So if pants was instituted for a man to cover up his behind, what you think the dress is for the woman? To cover up her behind.
Right.
You see that? So you can put a dress over your tights. You know, that's how you keep yourself warm in the winter. You put the dress on and you put the tights on to keep your legs warm. In the wintertime. My wife do that.
Nah.
You see, our wives do that. Everybody out here married and got wives, even the women in our church, they do that.
That's right.
Because why? They keep the commandments and they fear God.
That's right.
You know what the fear is, right? You know what the fear of the Lord is? Okay, we're going to give you the fear of the Lord. Yes, sir. How you doing, brother? We're teaching these commandments, bro. What's your name?
Lawrence.
Yeah. Hold on, Lawrence. Let me get this one scripture and I'm going to get with your question. Hold on, just a second. Let's get that.
Psalms 111:10. The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom.
That's the fear of the Lord, the beginning of wisdom.
Right.
When you fear the Lord, you fear his judgments, then that's when you become wise. Come on.
A good understanding have all they that do his commandments.
You're only going to have a good understanding once you keep these commandments. You start performing the commandments, you'll have a good understanding.
We used to scream black power while Heron was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission, minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road, purple and gold. From Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone, 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are how our men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.